The right-hand rules are often used to quickly determine the direction of the magnetic field produced by either a straight conductor or a solenoid or a coil wound on a toroidal core. Let's briefly review the right-hand rules to determine the direction of the magnetic field. So for example, the right-hand grip rule illustrated here lets you determine the direction of the magnetic field if you know the direction of the current. So essentially point the thumb of the right hand in the direction of the current, then the direction in which the other fingers point or curl is the direction of the magnetic field or the flex lines. Another way to determine the flex direction given the current direction is shown here. If the current enters the plane as indicated by this cross here, then the field B, magnetic field given by the B field, flex density field, or the flex lines is clockwise as shown here. If the current enters, then the field is clockwise and vice versa. So if the current is coming out of the plane as illustrated by this dot here, then the corresponding magnetic field is in the counterclockwise direction. So either of these two rules can be used to determine the magnetic field direction if you know the direction of the current. In fact, in these two figures here, the B and I are actually interchangeable, and that can be used to determine the direction of the magnetic field in a toroid or in a solenoid like the one that we're going to see in the next slide. So essentially what I mean is the current could be circulating in a clockwise direction as shown here, then the B field would be given by this cross that will be entering the plane. Similarly, if the current is in the counterclockwise direction as shown here, then the B field would be coming out of the plane. So this can be used, as I said, to determine the field in toroids and solenoids. Next, let's review the right hand rules for determining the direction of the magnetic field in a solenoid or a toroid. Here is a solenoid, and it has a current entering as shown here, and the current viewed from this side flows in the clockwise direction and eventually leaves the solenoid as shown here. Now, in order to determine the direction of the B field, the magnetic field, we need to wrap the fingers of the right hand around the solenoid in the direction of the current. So that would be illustrated by this right hand. The fingers point in the direction of the current, and then the thumb actually points in the direction of the B field in the solenoid. So the thumb points in the left to right direction. That is the direction of the B field in the solenoid. We can also get the same information by applying the concept that we learned in the previous slide. So it, again, viewed from this end, from left to right, what we see is a current flowing in the clockwise direction. So therefore, from this diagram, the B field should be entering the field as indicated by the cross. Therefore, the B field direction is left to right. Similarly, if you view the solenoid from this end, looking from right towards left, then what we see is a current that is actually in the counterclockwise direction. Therefore, the B field should be going, should be coming out of the plane, as indicated by the dot. Therefore, the B field is coming out again, as confirmed by the right hand grip rule that we used earlier. So, either of the two methods can be used to determine the direction of the magnetic field due to a current in a solenoid, and we can also extend the same concepts for analyzing the flex directions in a toroid as well. Okay, now if you want to determine the flex lines due to the current in this coil with the sensor winding as shown here, essentially the wire comes on top of the core, goes inside, comes out, and so on. So corresponding to this current and this orientation of the winding, the flex direction is again given by applying the right hand rule. So point the fingers, curl the fingers of the right hand along the direction of the current, then the thumb points in the direction of the flex, and that is in this direction for this situation. Now in the same core, if I use a different sense of winding direction, now the conductor actually goes below the core first, comes out at the top, then goes below, and so on. So just the opposite of the winding direction from the previous case. Now if we use the right hand rule, now once again the fingers point in the direction of the current, which is now reversed. Therefore the thumb points in the opposite direction, and that is the direction of the flex lines inside the core. So it's actually flowing in the counterclockwise direction in the flex, whereas for the previous case with a different sense of winding orientation, the flex lines were in the in the clockwise direction. Finally, we can also use the right hand rule to determine the direction of the flex lines corresponding to an EE core as shown here. So once again, if the current direction is as indicated here, then put the right hand fingers in the direction of the current, then the thumb in this case actually points in the upward direction, and therefore that is the direction of the flex lines in the center leg. And the flex lines start this way, and let me get this. So flex lines start this way and then complete their path in this direction in both the outer legs. So there are actually two parallel paths in the center leg. One goes to complete through the left leg of the core, and the other one completes its path through the right leg of the core.